I don't know about you, but I'm an old Keith Richards fan. I think Keith kind of by proxy taught me how to play rhythm guitar, for better or worse. I'm a big fan of that late 60s, very early 70s Rolling Stones material. And I've been sitting here with the XFX 3 thinking, I don't even know what guitars he used, to be honest. He may not have been using a Tele at the time. I think he was using Armstrongs and Les Pauls and stuff. But I've got a Tele here. I've got an XFX 3 here. I thought I'll have a crack at making some of those sounds into a preset. So here's my little preset called Early 70s KEEF. That's Soul Survivor, as you can see, and the amp I have chosen for Soul Survivor is the Double Verb Silver Face, which is a twin. I believe there was one at Nullcote when they recorded. I've put a little bit of tape saturation in there as well, and the cabs are Double Verb cabs, just a mix of those. So it's pretty good for that sort of cleany, exile-y kind of sounds. And it works well with the neck pickup too. This is a Seymour Duncan Mini. That's the other myth about Keith. We don't know which pickups he used. So anyway, that's scene one. If I go to scene, I'm just going to jump here because it's in a different tuning. If I go to scene three, I've employed the SVT Ampeg bass models, which are called the SV1 and the SV Bass 2. And you can see that I've got a little bit of mid and treble wound in there, quite a bit of drive, and I've got the SV cabs, and I've also got some tape distortion there as well, because it sounds like this. And if I put the capo on, I can kind of get that Scene 4 offers the same thing, but it's got a Double Verb cabinet and the matching speaker resonance to suit. Actually, it's a Princeton, sorry. Going crazy. And the cabinet is, yeah, the Princeton. So it's the Ampeg, the huge big old Ampeg, or the SV bass into the Princeton. As opposed to scene three. Sounds close as well, but it probably needs more treble, which pickup to use. There you go. So excuse me while I tune up to standard tuning for a second so we can move on. All right, sticking with scene three, I'm going to put the capo on to the 7th fret because I'm going to play this. There's that Ampeg sound again. I believe they were using the prototype Ampegs at the time, which used to blow a lot, and they swapped them for high watts a couple of times, but they came back to the Ampegs. Big amps, you wouldn't want to be carrying them around. Jeepers, they sound good though. And they were bass amps. Let's go to scene two and use the capo, still in the standard tuning, on the 3rd fret. And this will give you, put you in the ballpark for something like... I've used the tone and the volume to wind that down a bit, make it a little subtler. That's probably the proper speed. And what have we used for that one? We have the double verb silver face once again, a little bit of tape saturation in between. I'll show you what it's like without the tape saturation. So it adds something. And of course, the rotary block doing all of the swirliness there. The cabs are double verb cabs. What have I forgot? Nothing, I don't think. That's about it. So there you go. Some old KEEF-y sorts of sounds. Used different guitars, tried different pickups. I don't know what he used back then, so I'm just trying to approximate it, but it's still a bit of fun. Those amp picks, those SV basses are great fun. ¶¶